If you make websites for people and then later hand that website over to them and then they actually log into WordPress, what do you think their reaction would be if they logged in and saw this versus logging in and seeing something totally custom like this where you could pack in information on your services, tutorials that you might have, your contact form in case they need support, whatever that you want to put in there to bring them back to you, what do you think their reaction would be? Well, we're going to talk about that in this video, how to do that, and you can actually do this with pretty much all the page builders out there. So anyways, that's what this video is about. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. If you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell. This is a perfect opportunity to get your message in front of someone and make your websites more custom, every aspect, the outside and also the inside. And it's insanely easy to do something like this. Now, I'm doing this one with Elementor, but you can do it with Beaver Builder. You can do it with Divi. And I'm going to show you how some of the tools for that. I'm not going to show you how to do it with all those, but I'll show you some of the tools for that. However, this is a great opportunity to upsell, to have information about support, contact information back to you. You could put a welcome video in here. There's a variety of cool things you can do. And also the elements I would suggest using in a dashboard widget like this would be to make good use of accordions and tabs and things like that so you can fit more information in a tiny space. So let's look at the tools to be able to accomplish this for each of the different platforms. So for Elementor, there's a free plugin called Granular Controls for Elementor, and I'm going to show you how to use this in this video. If you're using Beaver Builder, there's Dashboard Welcome for Beaver Builder, and you can see from the image here, you're essentially able to do the same exact thing. Now, if you're a Divi user, there is a plugin for $22. It's called Divi Dashboard Welcome over at Divi Life. I have never used that. So let's go ahead and log in to the back end of this dashboard. Well, this is my dashboard. So just go to Plugins, Add New. If you're an Elementor user, and install Granular Controls for Elementor. As a matter of fact, I made a video about this kind of last week, some of the cool things that it does have a lot of features to it. But once you've installed and activated this plugin, there is a new settings option underneath Elementor right here that says Granular Controls. Now, this plugin does quite a few things that are really nice for Elementor users. As a matter of fact, someone left a comment on my blog a couple days ago saying how much he did not like Elementor because if you use the Elementor accordion module, the first accordion is open. So anyways, right here's an option to have it closed. So this is a plugin that fixes a lot of these little things that people might not like about Elementor. Just the little things though, overall Elementor is fantastic. So here's the accordions closed option. Here's just to simply remove the Elementor dashboard widget if that's something that you wanted. Then we have some other editor options. So these are your options when you're in the Elementor editor. Adding parallax and different things like that, but also adding the exit button. But what we're going to be looking at is the advanced settings right here. And so essentially, there's this option right here that says welcome panel. By default, it's set to no. And when it's set to no, it's just going to be your standard back-end dashboard. And this is what it will look like. It might look a little different on yours, depending on how yours is set up. But if you set this to yes, then you have an option to choose one of your saved sections or saved pages in the Elementor library. So you see, I created one called WP Admin Dashboard. So if I go to my templates, you can see here it is, WP Admin Dashboard. I can click on that and jump into Elementor, and you can see it is the same exact thing. So I can go ahead and drop a button in there, and let me maybe just drop that right there and have it to go to support, tutorials, or whatever. Whatever I do here is automatically going to get pushed to the dashboard. So if I click on refresh, you're going to see that page, and there it is. I've got my button there. There are so many things that you can do with this. So I'm going to give you a couple pieces of advice. Number one is I would use a white background. So when you're here, we have this white background. If you change the color of the background, you're going to have to play around with any kind of phantom padding or spacing. Let me show you what I mean. So if I go into the section settings right here, and let's just go ahead and change that background color just to something different. So there you can obviously see it, and I click on update and I go right here and I do a refresh. You're going to see what I'm talking about. You see, it's kind of framed a little bit, but it's not framed right. So we have a little bit of padding right here, a little bit of padding right here. I'm sorry, margin. We have some margin, but then over here on the right, there's like next to no margin. So it just doesn't quite look right. So that's why I suggest having the background color be white, or it's just not gonna look quite right or quite professional to how I would personally like it. So we can just go ahead and clear that, click on update, and you're gonna agree when I do a refresh that it just looks better. So it's just working along with it. And I would recommend having company information, a contact form, information about additional services. But the way I would accomplish it is I would go ahead and use the tabs module that Elementor provides. Here it is, tabs. I would go ahead and use that, maybe right there. Actually, you know what? The tabs module in Elementor isn't actually the best, and that's because you can't easily get Elementor elements in there. This is something that I think that they need to improve upon for sure, but you can definitely have some written information. So it could be contact information, it could be additional services or whatever, and it can be off to the side of a contact form like this, just to get a little bit more condensed information, maybe an accordion with frequently asked questions that someone might have. It's just about fitting in as much information as you can in this tiny little space right there. But it's an excellent branding opportunity for you. So anyways, I think this is a super useful, super helpful, something that will really make your work stand out above everyone else's work. And if you saw, it's super easy to pull off and it's not going to cost you a penny. So anyways, this is creating custom dashboards using Elementor. But like I said, you could do it in Beaver Builder and Divi. So let's go ahead and ask you, what do you think would be ideal to be in a dashboard widget here for your clients? What kind of information do you think would be best put in there to help it to be more of a customized solution for your clients? Go ahead and add that in the comments section down below. Hey, if you found any value in this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I will say thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.